evening, Mafia fans, and welcome to Mobster Moments. And I say Mafia fans because if you are, in fact, a true fan of the mob, as I am, when I say fan, I mean I'm interested in the history of it, then one of the movies that are required viewing is Martin Scorsese's Goodfellas. In my world, Goodfellas is second only to the original Godfather as far as the best mafia movies of all time. Be that as it may, there is a scene in Goodfellas that relates to the Tampa Bay area that isn't entirely accurate. And when we come back, I'm going to start to go over the scene and I'm going to tell you exactly what really happened in real life. The scene isn't too far from the truth. There's only one really glaring exception. But for the most part, unlike the scene in Donnie Brasco, this one here is more true to life. So having said all that, without further ado, let's get down to business. Now, in October of 1970, Hill and Burke, Henry Hill and Jimmy Burke, from now on I'm just going to say Hill and Burke, came to Tampa to collect a gambling debt from Gaspar, Ciaccio, and Dr. Felix Lo Cicero. And from now on I'm just going to say Felix and Gaspar. They owed money to Tampa mobsters Louis and Raul Charbonnier, who were working with Hill and Burke and working for their New York family. Now, the Charbonnier brothers ran gambling out of the Sharp Hall Lounge. That's the Sharp Hall Lounge, which Gaspar and Felix were in debt to the tune of about $13,000 each. Now, in the movie, the part about the zoo, that's all fiction. Jimmy and Henry never took these two individuals, or any one of them for that matter, to the Tampa Zoo. Actually, the zoo in Tampa is not even called Tampa Zoo, it's called Larry Park Zoo. So just forget about zoo because it's not in there. And when we come back, I'm going to tell you exactly what happened that particular evening. Okay, the Charbonnier brothers were working through a man named Cosmo Rosado. And he was a Tampa native who lived in New York at the time. He was a union boss of some sort. And Rosado actually came down to Tampa with Hill and Burke to attempt to locate these two guys who owed him money. Rosado treats Hill and Burke to a night out on the town at the famous Columbia restaurant in Ybor City, probably the most famous gangster hangout restaurant, which is still around, by the way, of any other joint here in the Tampa Bay area. After dining at the Columbia, the three go to the Temple Terrace Lounge, which Gaspar owned and worked at. Once they get there, they confront Gaspar and he refuses to pay. Well, like in the movie, they bring him into the backseat of a car and commence to whipping the ever-loving snot out of this guy as they're driving back to the Sharp Hall Lounge. Once they get to the Sharp Hall Lounge, they take him in the back and start beating him again. Only this time, they call Dr. Felix Lo Cicero and let him listen to the beating on the phone as they're wailing on this guy. Well, long story short, they both decide that they're going to go ahead and pay up. Smart move. Anyway, when we come back, I'll give you the conclusion. Okay, so the next day, after their night on the town, so to speak, Hillenburg leave Tampa and return to New York, only to find out once they arrive that they're going to be arrested. It turns out that Gaspar's sister, which is depicted in the movie, actually did work for the FBI. I'm not sure exactly what capacity. I think it was a secretary or something like that. And anyway, to make a long story short, Burke, Hill, their Charbonnier brothers, and Rosado were all charged with kidnapping, extortion, and attempted murder. Okay, there you have it. Now you know the true story regarding the Tampa scene in the movie Goodfellas, one of the best gangster movies ever made, in my opinion. As I stated earlier, I hope you enjoyed our latest edition of Mobster Moments. And with that, I say salute.